India on November 29, 2018, launched and placed in orbit successfully its best ever Earth imaging satellite so far, with 30 other satellites from other countries. Let's know more about it. ISRO successfully launched its PSLV C-43 rocket, carrying India's best ever high-resolution Earth imaging satellite, HISIS, a short form for Hyper Spectral Imaging Satellite. Besides this, the workhorse rocket also carried 30 small co-passenger satellites from 8 different countries, mostly belonging to the United States. This was the 45th flight of the PSLV and was launched from the Satish Dhawan Space Center, which is in Andhra Pradesh, at a place called Sriharikota. So, in total, Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle placed 31 satellites in two different orbits, one at a higher altitude and the others in a lower altitude. All the foreign satellites were placed in pre-designated lower 504-kilometer orbit. Important point to remember here is that HISIS is an Earth observational satellite developed by ISRO. It was the primary satellite of the PSLV C-43 mission. The satellite was placed in 636-kilometer polar sun synchronous orbit with an inclination of around 98 degrees. The mission life of the satellite is 5 years. According to the space agency, the primary goal of HISIS is to study the Earth's surface in visible, near-infrared and short-infrared regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. The picture on the right is your electromagnetic spectrum. Dubbed the Sharp Eye, ISRO chairman Dr. K. Sivan in his post-launch briefing had this to say about the satellite. It is a state-of-the-art satellite and an excellent space asset. It will keep a sharp vigil on the Indian subcontinent and help in identifying surface objects very accurately. We'll talk about it more in our applications section. And if you're wondering what is visible, near infrared and shortwave, have a look at the other picture. Just an add-on point about ISRO. Currently, that is as of 29th November 2018, it holds the record for launching the highest number of satellites in a single mission, 104. It happened on February 15, 2017. The PSLV's main passenger, informally called Chota Bhim after a popular cartoon character, weighs a relatively low 380 kgs. HISIS is a very rare satellite with a super sharp eye, and very few countries have indigenously mastered this technology. Many countries are trying to send such hyperspectral cameras into space, but interpreting its results, it's not easy and is a costly affair. The hyperspectral imaging or imaging spectroscopy combines the power of digital imaging and spectroscopy. For each pixel in an image, a hyperspectral camera acquires the light intensity, that is the radiance, for a large number, typically a few tens to several hundred, of contiguous spectral bands. Every pixel in the image thus contains a continuous spectrum of radiance or reflectance and can be used to characterize the objects in the scene with great precision and detail. Thus, hyperspectral images obviously provide much more detailed information about the scene than a normal color camera, which only acquires three different spectral channels corresponding to the visual primary colors, red, green and blue. Hence, hyperspectral imaging leads to a vastly improved ability to classify the objects in the scene based on their spectral properties. Engineers build these hyperspectral sensors and processing system for applications in astronomy, agriculture, molecular biology, biomedical imaging, geosciences, physics and surveillance. So to speak in a simple terms, certain objects leave unique fingerprints in the electromagnetic spectrum, the one which you saw earlier, known as spectral signatures. These fingerprints enable identification of the materials that make up a scanned object. So for example, a spectral signature for oil helps geologists find new oil fields. So if you are wondering who are the other countries, the countries comprise United States of America in total of 23 satellites, and others were Australia, Canada, Colombia, Finland, Malaysia, Netherlands and Spain, one satellite each. These satellites have been commercially contracted for launch through Antariksh Corporation Limited, the commercial arm of ISRO. Thus, ISRO also plays an important role in earning some foreign exchange by lending its capabilities to other nations, and also helps to improve India's foreign relations as well as goodwill. PSLV is ISRO's third generation launch vehicle. It can carry up to 1,750 kg of payload into polar sun-synchronous orbit of 600 km altitude. Altitude means height. Additionally, PSLV has been used to launch planetary missions and also satellites into geosynchronous transfer orbit. We'll talk about geo and sun-synchronous in detail in a separate video. But just to explain in short, the word synchronous, when used after geo or sun, means it follows their movement. Earth's rotation in case of geo and moment of falling sunlight in case of later. This consistent lighting is a useful characteristic for satellites that image the Earth's surface in visible or infrared wavelengths, such as the weather and spy satellites. Speaking about the future, all eyes are now on the launch of GSAT-11, India's heaviest communication satellite till date, from the French spaceport in South America, and it is going to happen on December 5th. After that, early next year, ISRO will launch the Chandrayaan 2 to the moon, where ISRO hopes to place a rover. Hope that was not too taxing. That was about the newly launched vehicle. In comment section, whenever you request for some videos, please try to be specific so that we'll be better able to understand your needs. Thank you and see you in the next one.